Hi, it's Carrie. In part 5 of Searching School, we're going to discuss using keywords. Keywords get called a lot of different things. In addition to keywords, you might hear them called natural language, search terms, text words, free text, and even more. Keywords are essentially any term that might encompass how a concept is referred to in the literature. Keywords, unlike subject headings, are not chosen from a thesaurus or database. They are made up by you. They can be absolutely anything. Do you need help thinking of keywords? There are a lot of things you can do to kickstart the creative process of coming up with keywords. Sometimes, if you found an appropriate subject heading in one of your selected platforms, there will be a section for entry terms in PubMed's Mesh, or synonyms in Base's M-Tree. There may be some useful terms there that you can copy and paste to use as keywords. This is especially important if you are searching for drug names. Embase's M-Tree is recognized as having excellent synonyms for chemicals and substances. You might also just complete a quick search for your concept on the internet. You'll want to see how your topic is referred to and incorporate any terminology you haven't thought of. I like a graphical dictionary called VisiWords. You can enter your search term and see related terms. This might help you think of additional terms. To start brainstorming, it will help you to keep a document and just start making a list. For any keywords you come up with, think about British or American English spelling variations, acronyms, plurals, hyphens, and other variations, and add those too. Are you looking for prevention? You'll need to look for cause. Are you looking for the benefits of an intervention? You'll need to look for harms. Think carefully about how your topic is most likely represented in the literature, and what bias you might introduce if you don't select your terms carefully. It is also extremely important that subject headings be duplicated as keywords. Subject headings are only searching subject headings. If you want the same term to be searched in the title, abstract, or other parts of the record, you'll need to include the keyword. Let's use our previous example of aromatherapy. We'd have the subject heading aromatherapy, which is a medical subject heading, and we'd also have the keyword aromatherapy, which is a keyword. It seems redundant, but this is of critical importance for systematic searching. Let's look at this example in PubMed. I'll search for aromatherapy in the Mesh database, and then I'll add it to the search builder and search PubMed over here on the right. Notice the number of results. I'm going to add or aromatherapy as a keyword. Please note that in PubMed, I put quotes around everything to turn off automatic term mapping, which is when PubMed maps your term to terms it thinks you want. But I prefer to have my terms searched exactly as I entered them and not mapped to anything else. Note that you should also use quotes anytime you want to search for a phrase, two or more words together in order. But back to our example, because I added the keyword for aromatherapy, I now get more results. More than I just did with the subject heading alone. And I can continue. I can add aroma space therapy. Now I have even more results, and that's due to the variation in terminology among publications, and not every publication gets indexed or is indexed reliably. If you are building a search or reviewing someone else's, ensure that all appropriate terminology is used for keywords. Ask yourself if any terms, such as synonyms or alternative drug names, are missing that should be there. Similarly, investigate whether irrelevant terms are listed that do not belong in the concept. I like to prepare my list of keywords for each concept and then build my concepts by adding the proper Boolean operators. You can do this manually or by using find and replace in your Word program. You can find and replace a hard return, which is caret P, with space or space. Please proofread for mistakes. When using keywords, some searchers will use truncation or a wildcard to search for word variations. Wildcards vary across databases, but the truncation symbol is universally understood as an asterisk. I use truncation a lot, but typically not in systematic searches because we don't know exactly what word variations are being searched. For example, in PubMed, we can truncate anything after four or more characters. We could use aroma asterisk to find variations in endings. I don't like to use wildcards or truncation in systematic searching due to the lack of transparency in most platforms to see what variations have been searched. This goes against systematic searching, which should always be reproducible and transparent. Something else to be aware of: PubMed operates with a phrase index. If you get an error in PubMed noting that your phrase is not found, it is probably because it does not exist in the phrase index. Instead, try searching each word separately with AND, which increases sensitivity but ensures that the terminology will be retrieved. In Part 6, we will investigate spelling, syntax, and line numbers.